Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to take a look at the new AccuRIG tool in Character Creator 4, which allows you to automatically generate a skeletal rig for your imported humanoid characters. Once the skeleton is rigged, we can also modify the skin weights for the character, create a facial expression system, and then send it to iClone for animation. Let's start by loading in our character. You can load your initial model in both FBX or OBJ format. However, if it's an FBX, you'll need to define it as a prop first, while OBJ import will automatically be defined as a prop. Once it's imported, you'll see it listed as a prop in the Scene Manager. Now, before we start binding the skeleton to our mesh, we need to make sure that the model is completely centered by zeroing out the transform values in the Attributes tab. We also want to open up the Preferences and enable World Axis Visibility. We can use the World Axis as a reference to align our character's local root position to. Please ensure that these are in the same position before continuing on. Let's move on to getting the body rig set up. You can find the AccuRIG button in the Attributes tab of the Modify panel. Right away, you'll want to ensure that your viewport is in orthogonal mode in order to restrict the viewport to precise camera angles for more accurate editing. The A, S, D, F, and G hotkeys will toggle between the various camera views, which you can also find from the toolbar. In the Skeleton and Bind Skin section of the Modify panel, you'll find an option for all or selected meshes. We only have a single mesh in this case, so we can select all meshes. If your character is made up of more than a single mesh, you can select the body mesh from the Scene Manager using the Selected Meshes option. If we click on Create Guides, it will proceed to automatically detect and mark our character's joints. When you select each generated joint, a dummy image will appear that you can use as a reference to ensure that the joint is placed in the most accurate position. You'll want to ensure that you look at the joint markers from both front and side view to achieve accurate placement. If you have symmetry enabled, then both left and right markers will move simultaneously. You can disable this if your character is not entirely symmetrical. Once all of the other joint markers are placed correctly, we can continue on to the hands. If I click the Frame Left Hand button at the top, it will switch the camera to focus on that hand. In the Skeleton and Bind section, you can choose the number of fingers from the drop-down menu and then proceed to click on Generate Skeleton. Just like that, your character's body is now fully rigged and ready for animation. There are a few ways that we can refine and test out the results, so let's get into that. The F3 hotkey will open up the Bone Manager, where you'll see a list of all the bones generated for your character's body. You can use the bone display settings to determine the size, color, and opacity of the bones in the viewport. If you want, you can also select bones and refine their position by using the movement gizmo. You can see that facial bones will also be generated in this process. Please note that the facial bones do not assign any skin weight values, but should still be in the correct position so we can define the skin weights later. Facial bones are generally used to open the jaw and move the eyes. Let's take a quick look at the hand rigging next. I'll again click on Frame Left Hand and take a look at the markers that were generated. Everything looks pretty good right off the bat, but we can tweak the marker positions slightly so that they align more closely to the knuckle positions of our model's hands. One important aspect to remember is that the thumb may be at a slightly different orientation from the other fingers. For this, there is a dedicated thumb direction gizmo that you'll want to position perpendicular to the thumbnail. Once you're done the left hand, you can move on to the right hand. If your character's hands are symmetrical, you can use the Symmetry Mirror tool to copy the results from the left to right hand. Once you're satisfied, then click on the Bind Skin button to generate the skin weights. This may take some time to process depending on the poly count of your model. Your skeleton color will change once that's finished, and then it's time to check the animation results. I'll click on Check Animation, and then proceed to apply a preview motion from the animation player. In this list, you'll find a bunch of different calibration motions that can be used, each focusing on different areas of the body. Full body will give this guy a decent workout as we ensure all of his body parts move correctly. There's also a hand test motion that will test out your hand rigging results. We can also apply motions from the Content Manager to test out as well. In order to adjust the skeleton further, we need to exit the check animation mode first. From there, we can again tweak the bone and joint marker positions to our preference. Keep in mind that when you're finished, you'll need to click on the Bind Skin button again to reapply the skin weight settings. You can reapply a test motion to see the refined results. Be sure to check from different angles as well. After you're satisfied with the results, you can click on the AccuRIG button once again to exit AccuRIG mode. You'll see that the character is now defined as humanoid, and it will be listed under Character in the Scene Manager. To look at the auto-generated skin weight results, you can enter into Skin Weights mode and click on different bones in the Bone Manager. If you find any glaring issues in your character's animation performance, you can often custom adjust the skin weight strengths and positions here. We'll cover that in a more advanced tutorial. Finally, we can send our characters to iClone using the Send to iClone button at the top toolbar. Once we do that, then our character is fully ready to be animated using iClone's arsenal of intuitive animation tools and features. With CC4 AutoRig, you can quickly and easily generate accurate skeletal rigs for your character, as well as modify skin weights and create a complete expression system, which we'll cover in another tutorial. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next video.